You've got your participants recruited. You're ready to go, but your potential troubles aren't over yet. You still need to worry about adherence. If you don't measure it and you don't report it, there's a good chance your research may not be reproducible. Adherence refers to the extent to which participants' behavior coincides with the directions they are to follow as part of the study. In a drug trial, for instance, it might correspond to a participant's actually taking the medication that they're prescribed in the manner directed. That's the topic of this module in experimental design. In an ideal world, researchers would have total control over participants. They'd be able to make sure that they do exactly what they're supposed to. In the real world, that almost never happens. Let's take an animal model first, where you might think adherence is easy. But is it? You can assign animals to diets to see how much that might affect their weight, but they might not eat as much as you'd like. Or perhaps you assign them to a drug, but they keep vomiting it up when you're not looking. There are critical steps between assigning a subject to an intervention and making sure that they adhere to that intervention. The latter is just as important as the former. After all, if you recruit a participant and then they don't participate, that's just as bad as not recruiting them in the first place. This is especially true with human subjects research. There are lots of reasons people might not adhere to the research protocol or be non-compliant. They're taking a drug. Maybe they had a side effect that led them to stop. Maybe they didn't understand the instructions they were given at the start of the trial. Maybe they just changed their minds and stopped doing what they were supposed to. Maybe they want to adhere, but they can't afford to. Maybe they don't have the support they need to make a change in their life. Some people randomized to control might find a way to get treatment anyway. This is another kind of lack of adherence. Switching treatment and control status is called crossover. With some trials, adherence is difficult. Dieters, for instance, have a hard time keeping a diet for an extended period of time. And those are people who are so motivated, they tried to make changes on their own. Can you imagine how hard it is for people randomly assigned to a diet to keep it? No wonder research in that area is so hard. For this reason, studies sometimes exclude people with a history of drug or alcohol abuse, or people who live far away, or people who have a history of mental health problems. Refusing certain participants will make a difference with respect to generalizability, but those concerns must be weighed against others. Good researchers will take steps to help participants adhere as much as possible, making it difficult for study subjects to figure out the proper dose of a medication is a surefire way to get them not to adhere. You want subjects to go to exercise classes? Make them free. Provide them with transportation. Arrange for childcare. Want them to adhere to a diet? You might consider giving them the food they need to eat, or at least great recipes, suggestions, or other things which might make the diets easier. Sometimes researchers can give participants reminders or check in with them, say, by phone, or text, or email. That's a great way to make sure they keep appointments, don't run out of medications, or remember to do what they're supposed to do. Recognize, though, that these are not real-world conditions. That threatens generalizability, or external validity too. But sometimes it's necessary to see if a treatment works, even among those who follow it closely. All the efforts in the world likely won't make all participants 100% adherent though. That's why it's also important to monitor adherence. That way, you know what you're really measuring, not just what you think you're measuring. If your study involves a drug, you can check to see how many pills people took by looking at their pill bottles. Even better, you could test them to see what their drug levels are. Sometimes you can get participants to help with this. They could record a food diary to keep track of what they ate in accordance with or in violation of their prescribed diets. If exercise is the intervention, participants could wear accelerometers to keep track of their activity. Your goal isn't to make sure that people are completely adherent. It's to try and maximize the chance that people are as adherent as possible and to record as accurately as possible the adherence they achieved. Taking the time to do so will help to make sure that future scientists who build upon your work will be able to reproduce your stuff as closely as possible. This training module is part of a series funded by the National Institutes of Health.